The Daisy Theater was an idea I had 20 years ago. I had written Tinka's New Dress, and as part of Tinka's New Dress, which was its own sort of fable based upon Joseph Skupa and the other Czech puppeteers working in Nazi-occupied Czechoslovakia. And I say fable because there were also political things happening in my world. You know, AIDS had started, and crazy statements from the government, and right-wing politics in Western Canada became unleashed. So I took Skupa's experience and my contemporary experience and fashioned this play, Tinka's New Dress, about a puppeteer who goes underground. And I thought in the writing it would be interesting to make his show really relevant and dangerous, and I thought the only way to do that would be to improvise those sections every night. So I made two characters, Franz and Schnitzel, who were a big, generous wink towards Schwebel and Hrvinek, and planned to improvise those sections every night. And I realized before we actually did Tinka's New Dress, I had no experience doing that with puppets. And so I built a little marionette stage and a bunch of characters that had nothing to do with each other, and booked a theater and announced that I was going to improvise a show for 2 hours a night. And my only source material was I would read all three newspapers, go out and talk to the audience and say, here's what's gonna happen. Very quickly, certain characters became beloved to the point of insanity, that people would come back three times a week to hear them. And some nights it was wildly political, some nights it was wildly filthy, other nights it was like a 12-year-old boy telling fart jokes, other nights it was deeply insightful and touching. It was whatever I'd eaten for dinner and what was in the news and what the audience was like, and it was the most satisfying thing I'd ever done. So that helped me with Tinka's New Dress for those improv sections, and I played Tinka for 8 years, and I think Franz and Schnitzel were were sort of the highlight of that show for the audience, because they knew the immediacy was about them being in the room. For many years, people would say, are you going to do the Daisies again? And I thought, oh no, I'm not that angry young man anymore. You have to be that angry, arrogant young man to go out and do that. And I've realized in the last year and a half, that I'm not an angry older man now. I'm a more informed person, and I think maybe my viewpoint has a little more weight and a little more moderation, which is interesting, and my performance skills have gotten better. So I just, in June of 2013, premiered the new Daisy Theater. And again, it was massively successful. Franz and Schnitzel came back. I redesigned them. There's an abusive old chorus girl, Hollywood star Esme Mazengill, who's probably the funniest and filthiest marionette I've ever made. And there were musical numbers. I would drag people up out of the audience to come manipulate puppets with me. It was all by the seat of my pants. And I realized I need to do this for the rest of my career. In between doing all the other shows I'm going to do and all the big pieces, I'm just going to now keep the Daisy Theater alive until the end of my career, because I think it's my working lab of how to remind myself of how to play with puppets and to play in the moment with the audience. And so in a way, it's kind of my Punch and Judy show, but it's with marionettes, because it's about right now. What happened in the news on the way to work that we can just metaphorically toss around and discuss? Because that's the great thing that I've learned about audiences. They come into the theater with the same frame of reference I do. They've lived in the same day, in the same world that I've lived in. So we all start off with the same stuff, and it's a great starting point. Oh, so the homage to Joseph Skupa, the name The Daisy Theater, comes from those underground shows that Czech puppeteers were doing during the Nazi occupation, which were called Daisies, because apparently the mythology, or the truth of it, is that a daisy can grow in the dark. And I've always loved that idea that no matter what socially or politically is going on and it feels bleak and dark, this little thing will pop its head through the dirt or through the concrete and live. And daisies are simple flowers, and I think I prefer that for the name as well, just because puppets are best, I think, when they're covert, when they're not really noticed, you know, when they can slide something in and you think, damn, I heard that in a puppet show, you know. So that is my huge, I was going to say hat off to Joseph Skupa. I actually I have my heart open to him every day, because he, his example showed me that you can be brave and that you can be in a noble profession. When a lot of times I look at my contemporaries in this field and I think, why are you squandering the most beautiful, delicate, robust, pure art form that people actually died for? Why are you, pardon my French, dicking around with my craft this way? So Joseph Scupa and a few others are in my mind and backstage with me every night before I walk on stage.